Technology has transformed the way we do almost everything, and it's finally innovating diabetes management.
I know how much carbohydrate there is, and based on that information, I can pre-program this little machine to give you the right amount of insulin.
Insulin pumps are not a new invention. They've been around since the 1960s. And with the advancement in technologies like continuous glucose monitors, traditional pumps are evolving into smarter devices. But companies have been slow to innovate them, so slow that a community of diabetics, including myself, learned how to hack into old insulin pumps by using instructions you can find online. The DIY system, or loop as it's called, works so well that thousands of diabetics started using it, despite the fact that it wasn't approved by the FDA and required you to maintain the system yourself.
I felt like I was looking at snake oil. Like, honestly, it looked like one of those weight loss ads where they say, take one pill and you'll lose 75 pounds. I said, there's no way this is true. But I pursued it and it built on my phone and I nearly fell apart crying after 2 days. It was a joy.
Because Loop is open source and doesn't require FDA approval, it has lots of features diabetics can't get from the commercial systems.
We have talked to the DIY community for a long time. They have very good ideas. And there's a lot of things that we want to implement into Control IQ and the t-slim pump that have come from them, and we plan to do that.
I just switched from Loop to Tandem's Control IQ, and after 3 months of using it, I could say it's a real game changer and that insulin pumps are finally getting smarter. Diabetes is becoming more and more prevalent. 34.2 million Americans have some form of it. That's one out of every 10 people. Roughly 5%, or 1.6 million, have type 1 diabetes. When you have type 1, the pancreas makes no insulin at all. Type 2 can be managed in a variety of ways, including diet, exercise, and medication. But a large number of the type 2 population end up needing to take insulin too. Insulin gets injected with a needle or through a pump. Without insulin, blood sugar will rise to unhealthy levels, causing serious complications or even death. Insulin pumps are meant to try and mimic what a normal pancreas would do, which is keep blood sugars under tight control.
Right now, the insulin pump users in the United States alone is between 350,000 to 500,000 people, depending on where you get the data from. That does include 30,000 to 50,000 people with type 2 diabetes using insulin pumps too.
Insulin pumps have come a long way. The device was invented in 1963 and was so big that it had to be worn as a backpack. Over the past few decades, they've gotten small enough to fit into a pocket or stick directly onto the body. They hold up to 3 days of insulin and use a needle to insert tubing under the skin. Medtronic and Tandem are tethered to the body with tubing. Insulet's Omnipod is tubeless, so it can be placed directly on the skin and uses a smartphone-like device as the controller. But traditional pumps don't work by simply putting them on. They need information like what your blood sugar level is and how many carbohydrates you're eating. Traditional insulin pumps do allow you to program a drip of background insulin all day, but the user needs to do the rest of the work. The size of the global insulin market was just over $4 billion in 2019, and is projected to grow over $8 billion by 2027. In the US, Medtronic, Tandem Diabetes, and Insulet dominate the market. All three have been working on hybrid closed-loop systems. Closed-loop systems work like this. A continuous glucose monitor sends blood sugar data to the pump. The pump uses an algorithm to target a specific blood sugar range and releases more or less insulin to keep you on target. It's hybrid because users still need to tell it when and how many carbs they eat. You can't just set it and forget it. Currently, only two systems are commercially available. Medtronic released the 670G in 2017, and Tandem just released Control IQ.
I didn't know anybody with type 1, so I didn't have anybody telling me what a great option it is. Like, look, I'm giving myself insulin by pressing these three buttons instead of drawing up an injection. I was like, oh, okay, that actually sounds amazing.
Managing diabetes with or without a pump can be very difficult. Diabetics need to keep their blood sugar in as normal range as possible to stay healthy and help prevent complications. The invention of continuous glucose monitors changed the way people interpreted and managed blood sugars. CGMs can read blood sugar levels every 1 to 5 minutes, replacing the need to constantly prick your finger.
The pumps have existed for several decades, but the CGMs have really changed not only diabetes outcomes, diabetes care just by themselves, standalone CGMs, but certainly as a critical component of making the closed-loop systems a success.
Now that a continuous stream of blood sugar data is available, the next step is to create an algorithm and close the loop. Insulin pumps with hybrid closed-loop systems are targeting a specific blood sugar value and then giving more or less insulin based on the CGM data. But allowing a computer to decide how much insulin to deliver can be a scary thing. Insulin can be very dangerous if a diabetic takes too much or doesn't get enough.
The actual math behind closing the loop is not that difficult. It's the same math that powers your thermostat, powers your cruise control. What becomes interesting is actually how you put all the pieces of the system together, how the pump, particular pumps are delivering insulin, how particular sensors are measuring glucose, and then how that algorithm takes all of those particulars and brings them together. You're balancing the time and range and the safety profile. And so it's that kind of secret sauce on top of just a simple control algorithm that you need to go through and then be able to get the FDA comfortable with to be able to get approval for a hybrid closed loop system.
The journey to get here has been long, but very rewarding. In 2010, 2011, we were doing inpatient trials, and those trials continued and continued and continued until the final pivotal trial this past year in 2019, which gives us Control-IQ as we know it.
Medtronic and Tandem are the only commercial FDA-approved systems on the market. They come with less features than Loop, but are covered by insurance and have the safety approval of the FDA. Tandem's Control-IQ is the latest to win FDA approval. The company says it has 155,000 people using its pump technology. It uses a touchscreen, and when the system has new features, you simply update it over Wi-Fi, rather than needing to order a brand new pump. Tandem stock has risen over 400% since June 21st, 2018, after the FDA approved its first automated software, Basal-IQ.
So our first algorithm is called Basal-IQ. It simply suspended insulin if the algorithm predicted that you were going to go low and get hypoglycemia. And so that was our first foray into devices that used algorithms. This algorithm is much more sophisticated.
Both commercial systems can adjust insulin rates every 5 minutes. Control-IQ has taken the automation a step further, with a feature that gives a bigger dose of insulin if it sees that blood sugar is getting too high.
The technology is all designed to reduce the burden of diabetes by automating a lot of the decisions that you would have to make yourself.
Medtronic 670G came to market in 2017. It's one of the largest device companies in the world. In a report from 2019, many users complained about technical difficulties keeping the pump in auto mode, referring to the hybrid closed-looped automated basal adjustments. It also had to recall some of the 670Gs due to incorrect insulin dosing due to a faulty piece on the pump. Despite these challenges, the company has 237,000 patients using the 670G system, and results from a recent study of its next system are showing positive results.
One suggestion for people making that switch to the 670G is just be really patient. And then for us, auto mode was never an issue. Once we turned it on, it was always on. But when we heard about the Tandem, yeah, it was really good. It was her doctor who has type 1 recommended it.
So I was still having high blood sugars. I was in the 300s a lot, and I still thought that it was so great. She was like, let's try this pump, and it's amazing.
Gweneth Stewart has had type 1 for 10 years. She's tried every closed-loop system available, even Loop, and is now using Tandem's Control-IQ.
The Medtronic sensor worked really well for me, but the Dexcom was crazy amazing when we got back onto G6, and it was like even more accurate than the Medtronic one was, which is really crazy because the Medtronic one worked really well for us.
Choosing between the two systems could come down to the CGM. Medtronic uses its Guardian Sensor 3 and requires calibrations with a blood glucose monitor. Tandem uses Dexcom's G6 and eventually Abbott's Freestyle Libre 2, neither of which require finger stick calibrations. But both FDA-approved systems still lack features users want, including personalized glucose targets and the ability to remotely give insulin, two features that have been available on Loop for years. The system uses out-of-warranty Medtronic pumps, or Omnipod Eros pods, an iPhone app you must build yourself, a Riley link to bridge communications from the pump to a phone, and a CGM. I used Loop for 18 months, building the app and maintaining it was a lot of work, and it lost connection quite often. But after 2 months of using it, my blood sugar levels dropped down into pre-diabetic levels. And so it was worth the inconvenience.
I think that Loop users in general are people that all the traditional commercial companies should go after. We're not people who are sitting around taking huge risks.
Katie DeSimone created Loop Docs, the step-by-step instructions on how to create the DIY Loop app on your phone. Her daughter Anna switched from Loop to Tandem's Control IQ and has been comparing the outcomes online.
I think the commercial companies should actually probably view Loop users as really a demographic that fits comfortably if they do their job with good commercial design. And I think that Tandem's Control IQ and the pump that they have is really doing that. And I do actually see a lot of Loop users would be really well served by Control IQ.
Control IQ has given me really great results and is less work than Loop. For whatever reason, if the pump breaks, I can just call up Tandem and get a new one because it's covered under a warranty. Now, the one issue that I have had with it is it loses connection with the CGM sometimes. Tandem told me that the Bluetooth signal actually comes out of the front glass-facing part of the pump. So for example, my CGM is on my right arm on this side of the body, and if I have the pump on this side of the body with the glass facing out, there is a risk that it'll lose connection with the Dexcom. The other thing that it's missing is a mobile app that can control the pump. Now, this was a feature that Loop did have, and it was really awesome. Tandem expects to update their app with this feature later this year. I've never tried Medtronic's 670G, so I can't compare the two systems. Before switching to Tandem, I used Medtronic pumps for 19 years and have always been happy with them. Insurance companies cover pumps for 4 years, meaning they won't cover the cost of another system until the warranty is up on the last one, adding a lot of pressure to make sure you are signing up for the system that will bring you the most benefit. I was not provided a pump for the making of this video and paid for it using my own health insurance. Without insurance, the Tandem system and 3 months of supplies would have cost me over $8,000. But with insurance, I paid $453. Those costs don't include how much I pay for the Dexcom sensors.
There are a lot of chronic diseases, but very few that require 24/7 management, such as type 1. That is pretty unforgiving for even a small mistake.
For those of us using these systems, having computers take over more of the work doesn't just improve our health, but it also gives us more time to focus on normal life.
I think kind of the biggest thing, it's not really quantifiable, but her mental peace, you know, she told me like the amount of thought that has been lifted from her shoulders because of it. It's like she didn't even know the burden because it's just life, you know, since she was 9.
And while these systems are light years ahead of insulin pumps of the past, there is still lots of room for improvement, better user experiences, and more choices.
The future for the technology in this space is really exciting. We do believe that it's possible to get to a full closed loop from a technology standpoint, where yes, these devices are there, but then there's no patient interaction required beyond getting those devices on.
Medtronic and Tandem just made a surprising announcement that the two companies are entering into a non-exclusive patent cross-license agreement. Tandem says the agreement is mutually beneficial and will allow both companies to innovate more freely and to make products quicker. As far as more options, there are lots of new systems in the works. Medtronic 780G is expected this fall in Europe, but has yet to be approved in the US. Tandem's T-Sport is due out in 2021. This pump will be half the size of its current model and will have the option to be controlled by a phone. Also coming in 2021 is Insulet's Omnipod 5, which will use a phone as the controller and will be the first tubeless closed-loop system. Tidepool is working on an FDA-approved version of Loop, not to mention a few other private companies with systems of their own.
It's still a one-size-fits-all. For these products that are coming out in the market, it has to be adaptable to or personalizable to a person and person's needs. And so there is significant room to improve the algorithms much, much further.
I feel so thankful that the pump will like be there helping me. It's like a little friend in my pocket just helping me out and like releasing me from some of the burdens of diabetes.